Hi, I'm Rich Hyndman. The L Developer Preview is well underway, and I'm here in the first of this series of DevBytes with a super quick rundown of the top features. The most important thing for developers is that there are system images available for the Nexus 5 and Nexus 7. So now you can test your apps and provide feedback to us on the Bug Tracker and Google Plus community. Head here and set your project to API level L to get started. And one thing you're sure to notice is the new Material Design Language. Material provides updates to the visual, the interaction, and the motion design guidelines. It replaces Holo and introduces a new theme.material along with APIs for activity transitions, shadows, reveals, and more. Notifications have received an update and now appear on the lock screen, letting you surface content, updates, and actions to users at a glance. There's three visibility levels that let you manage the information shown on secure lock screens. You have visibility public, where the entire notification is shown. Visibility private, where it's just the application name and unlock your device to see this notification. And visibility secret, that doesn't show on the lock screen at all. If you choose private, you can additionally specify a separate custom redacted notification, which would show on secure lock screens instead. Lock screens in the L Developer Preview no longer show controls for your remote control client. So instead, you should provide media playback control through a notification. Also, if you don't want the notification to be sent to the user's Android Wear device, you can use the new notification compat method, set local only. There is a non-compat version of the method as well in notifications, but it applies to API level 20 and above. Whilst mentioning API level 20, it's introduced as Android 4.4W. It's 4.4 with the wearable extensions. The L Developer Preview doesn't have its own API level, and apps built against it cannot be uploaded to play. We'll be incrementing the API level later on in the year for the L release. So if you check your SDK manager, you'll see there's two new SDK versions available, 4.4W and the L Developer Preview. If you're building production apps, build them against 4.4W. WebView has been updated to Chrome M36, which includes support for web audio, undulating monkeys, and WebRTC, making it our most advanced WebView yet. And another big behind-the-scenes update is the runtime. The Arch runtime replaces Dalvik in L, so please make sure you've tested your apps soon. Along with ahead-of-time compilation, improved garbage collection, and improved debugging support, also comes 64-bit support. The majority of titles in the Play Store are 64-bit ready and benefit with Arch as they're running purely DEX bytecode. Arch's not only beneficial for the memory footprint, but also for battery life, which brings us on to Project Volta. As J focused on jank removal and K made Android more svelte, there's a big effort in L aimed towards improving power tracking and doing something about power use. So there's new tools and APIs you can use to help save your user's battery. For example, APIs so that you can specify that a task should be done if the phone is charging, whilst on an unmetered network like Wi-Fi, and you want to guarantee that it would start within an hour. This is all done through the Job Scheduler APIs. There are also a couple of new UI widgets in the support library. We have RecyclerView, an advanced version of ListView, allowing you to display and animate rich dynamic collections, and CardView, that lets you display important information inside a card, which uses the new Elevation API in L. Next, we have the new camera API, Camera 2. It provides access to full resolution frames at full frame rate with per frame control of capture settings and calibration metadata. Staying with multimedia, we've open sourced the new video player called ExoPlayer. Built on top of Android's low-level media APIs, it includes support for Dash and smooth streaming adaptive playback, providing a new flexible way to enable video in your applications. Continuing in the same vein, we have audio updates as well. With low latency audio, multi-channel high dynamic range floating point mixing, and USB audio support. We've updates to connectivity with dynamic network selection with seamless handoff, and Bluetooth LE gets an update including peripheral mode. And then we have in order of size, Android Wear, Android TV, and Android Auto. Don't forget to also look out for all the I/O material on these topics. You can dive into Wear and TV right now as there are emulators available for both. Whew, that is one hell of a preview. We'll be going into more details on the topics in this video over the next couple of months. So stay tuned and happy coding.